pulmonary valves before going into the interventricular septum, because nature has decided to separate out the oxygenated blood flow and the deoxygenated blood flow first from the conotruncus septum, that is from the truncus arteriosus, conus aorticus, bulbus cordis, we have seen it. So the truncus arteriosus is continuous to become the pulmonary trunk, which is continuous with the right ventricle, and ascending aorta, which is continuous with the left ventricle, so that the deoxygenated blood from the right ventricle will go to the lung for purification, and purified blood will come to the left atrium, goes to the left ventricle, and from left ventricle to the ascending aorta circulated throughout the body. Okay, so let us see first how the truncus arteriosus has been divided into two portions, as the pulmonary trunk and the ascending aorta, to be continuous with the right ventricular cavity and the left ventricular cavity. Now this is the main truncus arteriosus base. First we'll see there is the endocardial cushion that will start appearing, superior and inferior. Then we'll see the anterior and posterior, they start appearing into this. So this valve is first is a truncated like this, and then divided into two separate valves, one at the base of pulmonary trunk, one at the base of ascending aorta. So first by the septum, truncal septum, it is divided into two parts, one part continuous with the pulmonary trunk, one part continuous with the ascending aorta. Now this is the axis of the rotation, here the two anterior, and this is one posterior for the pulmonary trunk, and this is two posterior, one anterior for the ascending aorta, we will see afterwards. Now this rotation, there is a spiral rotation of the truncus arteriosus, and so that is the rotation will give rise to the final position of the valve, pulmonary trunk and the ascending aorta. Pulmonary trunk is continuous with the right ventricle, it is arising from the right side, but it goes towards the left side, and ascending aorta is continuous with the left ventricle, arising on the left side and goes towards the right side. So that spiraling occurs because of the rotational movement. So this is how, this is the final position. Now if we see the word papa, P-A-P-A, papa, here is the word papa, in the pulmonary trunk start with P, so we will cut one P. So A, P, A, so two anterior, one posterior cusp is present in the pulmonary trunk. And in ascending aorta start with A, so we will cut one A, so two posterior and one anterior cusp is present at the base of the ascending aorta. So ultimately this is the position, there are two anterior, one posterior for the pulmonary trunk, there are two posterior, one anterior for the ascending aorta. So this is the position of the cusp of the pulmonary trunk and the ascending aorta. Now how the atrioventricular canal is being divided, you know that the atrioventricular canal is a continuous with the atrial cavity and the ventricular cavity. So this is a common atrioventricular canal, which is divided by this endocardial cushion. First there is superior and inferior endocardial cushion appears, then it will take the shape like this and cut off this. So this is the right side atrioventricular canal, this is the left side atrioventricular, separate from each other. This is guarded by the tricuspid valve, and this is guarded by the mitral valve or bicuspid valve. So the atrioventricular canal is also being separated by the endocardial cushion, so that the right atrium is continuous with the right ventricle and left atrium is continuous with the left ventricle. So the oxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood should not mix up. We will see afterwards the part of the interventricular septum is there called membranous part of the interventricular septum, which will separate the right atrial chamber from the left ventricular chamber. Okay? It is like inverted J-shaped structure. We will go into the details of the interventricular septum and we will see over there again. Now this is the spiral septum which comes in your short note to be right about this. This is the spiraling of the atrioventricular pulmonary septum. This is a canal. So first we will see the pulmonary trunk over here in the distal part, and this is the ascending aorta. There is the rotational movement, anti-clockwise rotational movement, and so what happens, they will be side by side in the intermediate portion. Ascending aorta, pulmonary trunk position is side by side. Then in the proximal part, let us see what happens. Ascending aorta will take the upper part and the pulmonary trunk will take the lower part. So this rotational movement takes place from the anticlockwise rotation of the spiraling of the trunk trunkus arteriosus, which will be ultimately forming the ascending aorta and the pulmonary trunk. So this is comes as your short form, which is very important. Spiral septum, specifically you have to prepare yourself. Then how does spiral septum is formed? How many cuffs are present in the ascending aorta? How many cuffs are present in the pulmonary trunk? These are very important. Okay. Now let me tell you, these all cuffs which is being formed, they are formed by the neural cast cells. All the bulbs will be derived from neural cast cell, which is very important. So any valvular defect of the baby will be also accompanied with the defects in the neural cast cell. This is very important information. Okay. So this is your the valve formation of the aorta and the pulmonary. First we have to see the outflow tract formation. How the deoxygenated blood, two lines have been separated. Then we'll see the interventricular septum, how the two ventricular cavities being separated out. Now in a household, let me tell you, the water which is coming from the drinking purpose and the water which goes from your sanitary purpose, from the washroom, they should not be mixing up. So that will be different source. That is to be first to be finalized. Then if this side is coming from the oxygenated blood, so opposite side will be diagonally opposite for the deoxygenated blood. There should not be any intermingling between the oxygenated blood and the deoxygenated blood. Similar to that, no intermingling in the drinking water and the toilet water or washroom water, there should not be any intermingling. So that is the basic things which nature follows in the development of the ventricular cavity separated by interventricular septum. We will see in the next class. Okay. That